Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are discussing paper code 878. This is a test series which is going on, and you can join this test series also. There will be video explanation of each and every question in this test series. Question number 51. Now it is given if secant theta plus tangent theta is equal to this. We have given this. Now you find two value, we have to find the value of sine theta. How will you find in such type of question? What you will do? You can cross multiply this 3 secant theta plus 3 tangent theta, which would be equal to 5 secant theta minus 5 tangent theta. Now this is 5, it would be secant theta, 2 secant theta, it will go this side, and 5 plus 3, 8 tangent theta. 8 tangent theta. You can say secant theta divided by tangent theta. Secant theta divided by tangent theta is equal to 4, and secant theta divided by tangent theta is equal to secant 1 by cos, and tangent sine theta like this. Then you will have 1 by sine theta is equal to 4. Sine theta would be 1 by 4. Sine theta would be 1 by 4. Answer is A. So the message for this question is that if you find such kind of question, you should cross multiply this. It will be easier to find the solution then. Now the next question, question number 52. The value of cot theta dot tangent 90 degree minus theta minus secant 90 minus theta cosecant theta plus sine square 25 plus sine square 65 plus root 3 tangent 5 degree tangent 15 degree tangent 30 degree tangent 75 degree tangent 85 degree is. This is the question. Now, this is English medium, this is Hindi medium, but we have to find. However, the statement is quite lengthy. Question is not difficult, but you need strong, carefulness in this question. You have to be careful, otherwise you can put the wrong value. So how will you do this question? Let us put value, and it is easier to put value of 45. So cot 45 would be 1. Let us do here only. Cot 45 would be 1. Tangent 90 minus theta, theta we have taken, we have assumed 45, 90 minus 45, that is tangent 45, which will be equal to 1. Now minus secant 90 degree minus theta, 90 minus theta, that is 45, because we have assumed theta 45, so secant 45, cos 45 is 1 by root 2, then secant would be root 2, and then cosecant theta sine 45 is 1 by root 2, then cosecant would be root 2, then plus sin square theta plus cos square theta. We can take it as cos square theta. Why? Because 90 minus 65, that would be 25, and cos 25 degree it would be. So we can write here 1, this would be sin square theta plus cos square theta formula will be used, and then plus root 3. Tangent 5, tangent 15, tangent, so this and this would become 1. 1 into 1 here, and then middle is tangent 30. You can say tangent 30 value is 1 by root 3. So the entire expression of this here, from here to here, is 1 by root 3. Because here you will find tangent 5, you can write here tangent 5 into tangent 85, which will be equal to cot 5, it will be cancelled. So in this way we have found 1, you can write here 1 minus root 2 into root 2, that is 2, plus 1, and here you will find root 3 into 1 by root 3, that is 1. So 1 3 minus 2, that is 1. Answer is A. So what we have done in this question, and what should you do in this such kind of question, you just put the value. You should take easy value so that it is easier to put, otherwise the calculation can be lengthy, because the statement in question is quite lengthy. But if you put value, then you can do mentally also, and it is easier also. Now this trick will be highly useful if you use in this kind of question. Question number 53. A, B, C and D purchases a gift with worth rupees 60. A pays 1 by 2 of what others are paying. It means A is equal to B is A is equal to B plus C by 2 because there are 3. There are four. In fact, there are 4 B, C, D. A, B, C, D. It would be, we can say 2A is equal to B, C, and D. A pays 1 by 2 of what other are paying. B pays 1 by 3rd of what other are paying. You can say 3A, 3B and A plus C plus D. 3B is equal to A plus C plus D. And then C pays 1 by 4th of what other are paying. You can say 4C is equal to 4C is equal to A plus B plus D. Now this is the actually question. Now if you find such kind of question, then what, how will you do? This is the question that I have explained this question. Now see, A, B, C, D total is 60. Now A, B, C and D 60. And BCD, in place of BCD you can write 2A. In place of BCD I can write 2A. And here 1. So 3A is equal to 60, value of A is 20. Similarly, in other cases also, A, B, here you can write, first let's write B, A, C, D. This is equal to 60. But here ACD is equal to, ACD equal to 3B. So 3B plus B, 4B. 4B is 60, then B is equal to 15. Similarly, here you can write C, A, B and D, which is equal to 60. But ABD is 4C. So 4C plus C, 5C. 5C is equal to 60, then C would be 12. Now 12, from this you can find the value of D because we have to find the value of D. So total is 60. And 15 plus 12, that is 27, and plus 20, that is 47. So 60 minus 47, that is 13, should be the value of D. Answer is B. What we have done in this question, we have worked according to the statement of the question. We have gone, we have rewritten the statement in this format, and after that we have put the value, then we could find answer. So you, such kind of question you can solve like this. Question number 54. Mohan gets 3 marks for is correct sum and loses 2 marks for is wrong sum. He attempts 30 sums and obtains 40 marks. The number of sums solved correctly each. Such kind of question you can do by option technique also. That is also easier. And many times I have solved such kind of question through option technique during this test series. But if each question is getting on correct 3 marks, if one question is correct, then it is 3 marks, 3x you can say, and minus, because from the total marks it will become minus. Then when we have, now total he attempted 30 questions, x he has done right, then wrong would be 30 minus x. And on each wrong, he is getting 2 marks. He is done, let's state, total question is 30. Right, he has done x. Then wrong, he has done 30 minus x. If he has done right, then he is getting 3 marks. So I multiplied by 3. And if he has done wrong, then he is getting 2 marks negative. So 3x minus this, then we have total score is 40. So you can say 3x minus plus 5x, and it would be then 30 into 260, it will go this side, you can say it would become 80, 60 plus 40, that is 100. So 5x plus 100, value of x would be 20. Answer is B. 20 question, otherwise you can solve through option technique. If 20 are right, 20 are right out of 30, then 20 into 30, 60, and wrong it means 10, 10 into 2, 20. So 40 he is getting, that's why he is here 40. From option technique you can do also, and otherwise you can do so like this. Question number 55. The cost of a manufacturer of an article was 900. Trader wants to gain 25% after giving a discount of 10%. This is the cost, CP. This is profit percentage and this is discount. We have to find the value of market price. So 900 CP, this would be 125 divided by 100 SP. Now into 100 by 90, this is MRP, and the value of MRP would be, you can say, 1250. Answer is A. Next question, question number 56. Two circles of a same radius, 5 cm, intersect each other at A and B. If AB radius intersect each other A and B, which you can write in this format, A and B, they are intersecting this, and the radius 5 cm you can write here, 5 cm right here you can. This is the midpoint, this could be midpoint, these two. So what is the question? If AB is 8 cm, then it would be 4 cm. This is 4, this is 5. You have to find the distance between these two centers. You have to find the distance. If this is 4 and this is 5, according to the Pythagoras triplet, it would be 3. And according to 5, 4, 3. Because 3, 4, 5 is the triplet combination. 3 plus 3, that is 6, should be the answer. Next question, question number 57. A contractor undertook to finish certain work in 124 days and employed 120 men. After 64 days, he found that he had already done 2 by 3 of the work. Now, men 120 in 64 days. In 64 days, it means these are man days, which is equal to 2 by 3. Which is equal to 2 by 3. Now, remaining work is 1 by 3. So, these men, 1 by 3 would be equal to, you can say, in place of 120, you can write here 60. Into, this is the man days work which is remaining. 2 by 3, in place of that, if you want to make it 1 by 3, then also divide by here 2 by 2, that is we will have 60 into 64, that is the remaining work. 60 into 64, this is the remaining man days. Now, to complete 60 into 60 unit, you can say, or otherwise man days, you can say, how many men can be discharged now the work may finish in time? Days required is equal to already 64, 60 days are remaining. 60 days are remaining. It means 64, total 64 men are required. 64 men are required, but already working 120. So 120 minus 64, that is 56. Now the employer can release 56 persons. Answer should be 56, that is B. What we have done in this question is that 64 days 120, this is the total unit of work which is equal to 2 by 3. To make it 1 by 3, I divide by 2. Now this is the main days which needs to be done. You can say, you can also assume it number of unit, this is the total work which is to be done. Now which would be equal to number of men days into time, days into men, days 60 and men x we have taken. So x, that is 64 people will require, but he has already 120, so he can release 56. Answer is B. Next question, question number 58. A sum of money is sufficient to pay A wages for 21 days and B wages for 28 days. The same money is sufficient to pay the wages of both four. You can say A and B, A 21 days, 28 days. Now take LCM. Otherwise, you can take, you can say 21 into 28. You write this way. It would be then 28 here and 21 here. 28 plus 21. That is 49 and 21 into 28 days. You can say 12. Otherwise, you could have done like this: 120, 1 by A plus 1 by B. You will find A into B and A plus B. After reversing this, you will find A into B. Otherwise, in this, you will find A into B and A plus B. You can convert in this format immediately also. So answer is 12 days. Next question, question is 59. In a triangle ABC, A, B and C is equal to 2, 3 and 4. This is the ratio of, you can say 2x, 3x and 4x. 9x is equal to 180, value of x is 20, because the total sum of total angle would be 180. One angle is 2x, 3x and 4x, so where it would be, you can say 40 degree, 60 degree and 80 degree. A line CD drawn, let's make this diagram then, A, B and C, 40, 40, 60 and 80. A line CD, this is 80, you can write 40 and 60. A line CD drawn to AB. This is line CD, C and D, or otherwise you can also write it AB. Then ACD would be A, C and D. You have to find the value. This is parallel to this. This is parallel. Now, if this is 40, then this would be 40. Why 40? Because this would be alternate angle. 40 and this would be 40. Answer is A. So this is a alternate angle. You can say it like this. If this is 40, then this would be 40. Question number 60. In this question, it is given cos x plus cos square x is equal to 1. Numerical value of this expression we have to find. You have to find the numerical value of this expression. So if you see this expression very careful, then you will find sine 4 theta, or you can write x here, plus sine square x and cube of this is equal to this. Minus 1, here you write minus 1. This is equal to this. If you see very carefully, sine, you can say a4 plus b4, b2. If you find, if you elaborate this, then it will be converted into like this. Now, and cos x is equal to 1 minus cos square x, which is equal to sine square x. So in place of sine square x, here you can write here cos square x. In place of this, you can write, because sine square x is equal to cos square, then sine square 4 x would be cos square x plus sine square x, and this is equal to 1. This is equal to 1. 1 cube of 1 is equal to 1 minus 1, that is 1 minus 1, 0. So answer is C. What is the important observation in this question is that this expression is equal to this. We have to think in that term. And how can you get a clue? Clue you can get from this. 3. Because A plus B, if I write this, then expression is A3 plus B3 plus 3AB and A plus B. This is the equation. So if you elaborate this, then you will find in this format. Question number 61. Now A, B, C walk 1 kilometer in 5 minutes. 1 kilometer in 5 minutes, 8 minutes and 10 minutes respectively. C start walking from a point at a certain time. B start from the same point 1 minute later. And A start from the same point 2 minutes later than C. Then A meets B and C 8 times. This is the question. And if you find such kind of question, read this statement very carefully. This is little bit lengthier question, but you will see the total. Then it is, you can say, the such kind of question will create the difference that will tend to towards getting a job. Now 1 kilometer is the distance. 1 kilometer, it means 1 kilometer 5 minutes. 1 kilometer, you can say 1000 meter in 5 minutes. So speed of A is 200 meter per minute. Per minute, this is minute. Now B is traveling 1000 meter in 8 minutes. 1000 divided by 8, that is 120 meter per minute. This is the B speed. And speed of C would be in 10 minutes. 1 kilometer distance in 10 minutes. It means 100 meter per minute. This is the speed of a C. And after that, what happens? C starts, now the slowest person is C. C start walking from a point. This is the here, you can take C start from here, from a point at a certain time. B start from the same point 1 minute later. Now after in 1 minute, C has reached here. C has crossed 100 meter. Now he is here, 100 meter ahead, you can say, from B. And in 2 minute, in 1 minute later, A start from the same point. After that, A start, and 2 minutes later, B start after 1 minute, and B start after 1 minute, and A will start 2 minutes after C start. It means when C reaches 200 meter, B will reach. Because B is slow, in 125 he has traveled in 1 minute. So you can say 120, C has reached 200 meter distance, B has reached 125, means gap is 75, and A will start. It means the difference between A and B is 120, and B and C is 75 meters. Question is, then A meets B and C 8 times. At what time A will meet? You can say to C, this 200 meter is the distance, and to cover this 200 meter, this is the relative speed is 200 minus 100, that is 100. Relative speed of this A and C is 100, and to cover this gap of 200, A will take 2 minutes. A will take 2 minutes to cover the distance of C. Then another question, then A meet B and C. So answer is this, because this is C. A will meet at C 2 minutes later. To verify further, you can also solve. This is the answer. Otherwise, you can also go ahead. And what is the ahead? See, A and B. Let's A comparison of A and B. So when B will travel 125 meter, and the this is the, you can say A and B, 75 meter is the relative speed, 75 meter per minute is the relative speed between A and B, and total distance that A has to cover to meet B, that is 125. So you can say 5 by 3 is the time that will take A to cross to meet B, and 2 minutes A will take to meet C. So A is the answer. Next question, question number 62. BL and CM are the medians of a triangle ABC right angle at A and B. This is very good question. At A and BC is equal to 5 cm. If BL is 3 root 5 by 2, then the length of CM, this is right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. And BC is 5. This is 5. Because BL, this is B, this is C, and this is A, and BL median is mid, this is the midpoint, and from the vertex that is B, if we meet these two points, then this would be the median. It means if this is X, then it could be X. In median, divide the opposite sign to equal part, and this is CM, this is also median, C and M. It means if this is Y, this is also Y, because it will divide, BD will divide into two equal parts. And the given is, this is given BC, hypotenuse is given BC of this triangle, right angle triangle, BL. This is B and this is L, which is equal to 3 root 5 by 2. And the length of CM, we have to find the length of CM. We have to find the length of a CM. So always see, this is Y and Y here, that is, you can write 2y square, 2y and whole square, that is 4y square. You can write this is plus x square, which is equal to, you can say square of this and square of this is equal to square of this, because this is according to the Pythagoras theorem, a square plus b square is equal to c square, and this is right angle triangle. So square of this would be 3 into 3, 9 into 5, 45 by 4. 45 by 4 you can write directly, 45 by 4. Now in this expression here, 2y square, the 2y and whole square of this, 4y square you can write. We are discussing now this part, this triangle, 4y square and then 4x square is equal to 25. You can say AB square and AC square is equal to 25, and AC square is also 2x and x, that is we have taken 4x. Now in place of in place of 4y square, you can write 45 by minus x square in place of 4y square. So 45 by 4 and minus x square, but this is minus x square, this is 4x square, which is equal to 25. You can say 3x square, this is 3x square, and 45 minus 45 by 4, you can write 50 by 4. Or in other words, x square is equal to 55 by 12, x square. Now we have found the value of x square. Ultimately, what we have to find is, we have to find the value of this. You can say y square plus 4x square value. We have to find the value of y square plus 4x square. Now 4x square would be, you can multiply 4x square. So multiply it by 4, 53 by 3. 55 by 3, this is 4x square. Y square, from where we have to find the y square. Now see, the y square you can find from here. Here value of x square was 55 by 12. So 4y square is equal to 45 by 4 minus 55 by 12. You can write here, this will be the value of y square. From here we can find out. So eighty by twelve, four y square. You can say y square is equal to 5 by 3. So we know the value of y square, which is 5 by 3. We know the value of a 4x square, which is equal to 55 by 3. So if we add a square plus b square, which is equal to c square, that we have to find. This is the value according to the Pythagoras. That is equal to 60 by 3. This is c square, that is 20. So root of 20 would be the exact answer. Root of 20, which is equal to, you can say 2 root 5 is the answer. 2 root 5 is the answer. So what we have done in this question? See, this is given and this is given, but we have to find the value of this. So what we will do? This square, you can say AB square and AC square is equal to BC square, and in a second equation we have made AB square and AL square, which is equal to BL square. During that process we divided y and y, x and x. So accordingly we have calculated the value of this and this. After that we can find the value of this. However, this is lengthier question, but this is good question, and it can take, if you have practiced, it can take time around 1 minute or more than 1 minute also, but this kind of question will create the difference. 63. The average age of 14 girls and their teacher is 15 years. It means 15 total number of people, average is 15, total 225. If the teacher age is excluded, average age reduces by 1. We can say 14 into 40, 196. Teacher age is 29. You can say 25 girls, total number of girls plus teacher, average at 15, 15 into 15, 225, and if we exclude teacher, average is 14 into 14, 195. So the difference is due to the teacher age, which is 29. Question number 64. Sin theta plus cos theta, A sin theta plus B cos theta is equal to C, then the value of cos theta minus B sin theta. If you find such kind of question, what you will do? When you find in this format question, what you will do? Always multiply it, squaring and adding. Use the trick of squaring and adding. So if I square to this side, square this side and then this side, which is equal to, let's say, x. So it would be x square. So what will happen? A square sin square theta plus b square cos square theta plus 2 a b sin theta cos theta, 2 a sin theta b sin theta, means a b sin theta cos theta, you can write directly. What we have done, we are doing squaring and adding. So this is equal to squaring of this would be cos square theta, a square cos square theta plus b square sin square theta and minus 2 a b sin theta and cos theta, sin theta cos theta, which is equal to c square and x square, which we have to find the value of x and c square. Now see, this and this would be cancelled. And if you take common a square in this, then we will find here sin square theta and then plus cos square theta. and then b square if you find cos square theta plus sin square theta. So sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. You can write a square plus b square is equal to, you can write here minus c square. You can take to this side, which is equal to x square, and x square and root of this would be the value of x, which can be positive, negative, both. A square plus b square minus c square. A square plus b square minus c square. B should be the answer in this question. So such kind of question, how will you find squaring and adding? Answer you will get immediately. Question number 65. The value of a machinery depreciates every year at the rate of 10% on its value at the beginning of that year. If the current value of the machine is 729, it's worth 3 years before. It means it was less 3 years before. And when there is less, then you will have 100 by 90. Remember, in this type of question, you, if it is asked earlier, then 100 will be on denominator, and if it is depreciation, then 90. If it appreciation, then it would be 110. Now you can say it will be cancelled like this, so we will have 1000 value. Answer is 1000. Next question, question number 66. Arithmetic mean of the score of a group of students in the test was 52. The brightest 20% of them scored a mean score of 80 and the dullest 25%, a mean score of 31. The mean score of remaining 55% would be how much? Remaining 55%. It means total number of students 100. 100, and the arithmetic mean of the score of a group of students in a test was 52. Brightest 20 are getting 80 score. 20 into 80 total score, plus 25 mean score 31. So 25 into 31, and the remaining score is 55. Brightest 20% of them scored a mean score of 80, and dullest 25% mean a score of 31, and remaining, which is 55, this is 55 because 20 plus 25, 45, and remaining is 55, and average that we have to find, and we have taken x. Now the total score is this, total score divided by 100, you will get 52. Why 52? Because the average of total 100 students is 52, which is given here. Total number of student and total score, if we divide to total score by 100, then we will have average score. So let's write it, this is 1600 plus 775, and this would be 2375. So 55x is equal to 5200 minus 2375. 2375 would be equal to 5, 2, 8, and 2, is equal to 55. If we divide to this, then we will have the value would be equal to 2825 by 55. So we will have 51 point something. Answer is B. 51 point something. Answer is B. Next question, question number 67. A swimmer swims from a point A against a current for 5 minutes and then swims backward in favor of the current for next 5 minutes and comes to the point B. If AB is equal to 100 meter, then the speed of the current in kilometer per hour. Very good question. How will you find A swimmer swimming from a point A, let's point this is A, against a current for 5 minutes. For example, this is A for 5 minutes and then swims backward. He is then swimming backward in this direction, you can say. But he will travel more distance, obviously, because this is with the stream and this is against the stream. So, during the backward, you can say he is coming back, then he will travel more. And in 5 minutes, time is here 5 minutes and here also 5 minutes. In minute and comes to the point B. This is point B. If AB is this AB, this is 100. The distance is 100. The speed of the current in the, we have to find the speed. So if this is 100 meter, this is 100 meter. So let's take this is D. This is the distance. Total distance, this is 100, this is D. Distance and this is time. Distance divided by time will be speed 100 d by 5. This is the speed and speed which is equal to x plus y, x minus y, sorry, because this is in opposite direction. D by 5, d is the distance and 5 is the minute. Distance divided by time, that is speed, and the speed is upstream, x minus y. And 100 plus d, 100 plus d, this is the total distance according to the downstream, and time to, total time taken is 5. Time taken is 5. So that is equal to x minus y. X plus y in this case, because this is downstream. Total distance divided by time, it would be speed, which is equal to x plus y. Now, in place of d, you can write this x minus y, 5x minus 5y, you can write 100 5x minus 5y is equal to 5x. Now, it will go to this side, 5x plus 5y. Now, it will cancel. 10y is equal to 100 and y is equal to 10. Now, what is y? Y is the current speed and x is the still water speed. So, value y is 10. 10, this is what we have found, 100 meter per minute. But we have to find the value in kilometer. So, 10 meter per minute. In 1 hour, it will travel. If 10 meter in 1 minute, then 60 minutes it will travel 600 meter. But to 600 meter, which is equal to, you can say, if I divide by 1000, that is 0.6. 6 by 10, in other words, 600 by 1000 is equal to 0.6. 0.6 is the answer in kilometer per hour. Next question, question number 68. A person observed that he required 30 seconds less time to cross a circular ground along its diameter than, this is the circular ground, along its diameter, this is 30 minutes, he is taking 30 seconds less according to this diagram, diagonal, then to cover it once the boundary. Once means this is once boundary. If his speed was 30 meter per minute, then the radius of the circular ground would be how much? So this is 2r and this is 2πr. 2πr, total distance, and divided by 30 minutes. 30 minutes per minute. Distance divided by speed, that is time, minus, this is 2r. 2r divided by 30, which will be equal to, 30 seconds, which is 1 by 2 minute. 30 seconds means 1 by 2 minutes. Now, this is the expression. Total this, that this is circumference, which is equal to 2 pi r. Distance divided by speed, that is time, this time and the difference of this time. What of this? What is this time? That is diameter, this distance divided by speed, and then the difference is difference of the timing is 1/2 minute. That is 30 seconds. So you can take common here. You can take common 2r/30. And then pi, that is 22/7 minus 1 is equal to 1/2. So you can write here value of r. We have to find the radius value of r would be, let's how much is this equal to 15/7 into 2r/15 is equal to 1. R is equal to 7/2. Answer 7/2 means D should be the answer. Next question, question number 69. And what is this question? The greatest common divisor of 3/3 and power than 3 + 3 + 1 and 3/3 and power 3 + 3 + 4 + 1. We have to find the greatest common divisor which can divide to both. Now see from the option, one cannot be greatest. If let's see, it is also possible if these are prime number, but these are cannot be prime number. This cannot be prime number. Let's see what is the unit digit in this case, and let's see what is the unit digit in this case. So from that we can also find, from that a press use of option we will find the value. So see the value of a 3 × 3 × 3, that is 27, or you can say power of 23 × 3. This is +1, and again 27/3 + 3 = 4 + 1. It would be equal to, see, 7 1 7 2 7 3 7 4 and 7 5. Again it will repeat. For example, 7 49 it would be, and then after 4 7 5 4 it will repeat again. It will repeat again. So if I divide by it by 4, then we will have, it means 1 is the remainder in this case. So power of, this is 7, power of 7, 1 we will have, unit digit is 7. So 7 + 1 = 8. In the total value of this, in the unit digit we will have 8, and here we will find 7, and if I divide by it 4, why 4? Because after every 4 it is repeated. So we will have here 2 is the remainder. So 7/2 + 1, that is 9, and +1 = 10 is the, you can say 0 is the, in case of this 0 is the unit digit in this expression. So it means 8 is and 0, these are two numbers. So obviously 1 cannot be, 20 cannot be, because it is not here the 0. So it would be 2 would be the answer. 2 would be the answer in this case, because it will not divide. It will not divide to, you can say this. Now the answer would be in this case A. Question number 70. The value of this expression, we have found the value of this expression. See, 80, we can write 284, 16 × 5, and root of 16, that is 4, 4 √5 we can write here, minus. Here we can write 16 × 7, that is 4 √7. 16 × 7, root of 16 is 4. And to this expression we can write here, you can 9 × 5, that is 3 √5. 9 × 5, and root of 9, that is 3, and here 9 √7, 9 × 7, root of 9 is 3 and 7. Now take common 4 in the upper numerator, then we will have root 5 plus minus root 7. And here take common 3, then we will have root 5 minus root 7. It will cancel. 4 by 3 should be the answer. 1 plus 4 by 3. 4 by 3 is the answer. C is the answer in this case. Question number 71. ABCD is a rhombus. AB is produced to F and BA is produced to E such that AB is equal to AE is equal to BF. Then we have to find which can be the correct. Which can be the correct. ABCD is a rhombus. AB is produced to F. Let's make rhombus. Rhombus is when all four sides are equal and opposite sides are parallel. A, B, C, D, right? A, B, and C, and D, this is rhombus. A, B is produced to F. Produced means in this will be enhanced, manufactured to F, A, B, F. And B, A, B means B and A to this side. It will be produced to C, E, E. You can right here like this. This is E and this is BF. So that AB is equal to AE. AB is equal to AE and ABF. These are three equal. These are three equal. Then we have to find the which expression is correct. Which is the correct? ED. What is ED? This is ED. This is ED. CF, this is CF. Actually, we have to find the relationship of AD, ED and CF. So, it is whether it is more than this or not. We have to first we have to establish the relationship, or in this other whether it is making like this 90 degree or not. Making this 90 degree or not. This is 90 degree or not. ED square plus CF square is equal to EF square. Is equal to EF square. This is another expression. And ED parallel to CF. ED parallel to CF, that cannot be possible. This is very, very clear. Now, either it can be this answer, this cannot be possible because ED and CF. If this is the, these are the same, then now let's see. Let's take here the angle. For the simplicity purpose, we can take here angle 100. If we take, for example, 110, we have taken this, then it would be 70. It would be 70. And then it would be 110. These are two equal. Why equal? Because this is rhombus. If this is 110, this is 110, then it would be 35. Because this would be 70 both angle. It means 35 this and 35 this. This is 35 angle. And if this is 35 and this is 110, 110, then this would be 35. This would be 35. And if this is 70, if this is 70, and this is 70, this would be 110. Both of these would be 110. Means 55, 55. This would be, if this is 50, 70, this is 55, then it would be. This would be 55, because 55 plus 55, 110 plus 70, 110. This is 35, this is 55, that is 90. And it means this would be 90. This would be 90. It means this is perpendicular to this. So this is B is exactly right answer. We could find the value by putting value. You can put another value, you will find the same answer. So in this way, answer is B. Question number 72. Three sides of a triangular field are of length 15, 20, and 25 long respectively. Find the cost of sowing seeds in the field at the rate of 5 rupees per square meter. This is triangular. 15, 20, and 25. This is triplet. 15, 20, and 25. This is triplet. You can say 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10. Similarly, 9, 12, 15. and 12, 15, and if you see 15, 20, this is why everything is divided by 5, then you can remove this, because this was to explain only triplet, the concept of triplet, and important triplet you must remember, this will be highly useful. So this is triplet, and what is the question? Area of this, area is 1 by 2, 20 into 15, this is the area, you can say 100, 15 into 10, and the answer is 5 rupees per square meter, 10 into 15, 150 is the area into 5, 750 rupees is the cost that will incur by for sowing seeds. C is the answer. Question number 73. If x is equal to a secant theta cos theta, here this is in fact theta, this is theta, and we have to find the value of this expression. So x is equal to given this, and y is equal to given this, and c is going to equal to this, and we have to find the value of this x by a. If you write in this expression x by a, then x by a is equal to secant theta cos theta. So I can write secant theta and cos theta, value of this, and but this is square, so you can write secant square theta cos square theta, plus y divided by b is equal to secant square theta plus sine square theta plus z by c. This is minus, in fact this is minus, because this is minus, z by c would be equal to tangent theta, and it would be tangent square theta, because this is square. So take common here secant square theta, then we will have cos square theta plus sin square theta minus tangent square theta, and this is equal to 1, so secant square theta minus tangent square theta, and which is equal to 1. Answer is 1. A is the answer. So this is, if you put the value, this is easy question, however it seems little bit confusing, but this is very easy question if you just work according to the statement. Question number 74. If a b c are non zero, then a plus 1 by b is equal to 1, and b plus 1 by c is equal to 1, then we have to find the value of a into b into c. Here it is given a plus 1 by b is equal to 1. If I multiplied both sides by b, then we will have ab. Here I multiplied by b, and then here this side also b, and ab plus 1 is equal to b. You can say ab is equal to b minus 1, but we have to find the value abc. Now c in this expression, 1 by c is equal to 1 minus b, so c would be equal to 1 minus, so if I multiply c is equal to 1 minus b, abc is equal to b minus 1 and 1 minus b. In other words, you can write 1 minus b and 1 minus b cancel, it would be equal to minus 1. Answer is a, minus 1. Easy question, however it needs little more alertness, otherwise it can be wrong also. Question number 75, which is the last question, and in this question, a godown is 15 meter long, 12 meter broad. The sum of the area of the floor and the ceiling is equal to the sum of the area of the four walls. This has become like cuboid, you can say. The volume of the godown would be, volume is L into B into H, and L we know 15 and 12 B, and we have to find the value of H. How will you find? Godown 15 meter long and 12 meter broad, the sum of the area of floor, and area of floor is 15 into 12, that is 180, and this is also the area of ceiling, that is 180. floor and ceiling is, that is, this is 360 is equal to the sum of the area of four walls. 360 is equal to perimeter into height is the area of four walls, perimeter into height, and perimeter is 215 plus 12 and into height. So you can say you will find here S would be equal to 15 plus 12, that is 27 into 2, 54, 360 by 54. You can say 20 by 3, S is value 20 by 3. So in place of S, if I write 15 into 12 into 20 by 3, then we will have answer. 1200 is the answer of this question. What we have done, LBS is the volume. We know L into B and we have to find the value of H. We couldn't find area. This is for some of the area of four walls would be perimeter into height, and perimeter is 2 L plus B into H, and which is equal to area of floor and area of a ceiling. So 100 plus 100, 360. So value of H we could find 20 by 3. And if I multiplied by 20 by 3, then we would answer is 1200. B is the answer. So in this question paper, we have covered all mathematics question. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.